So I think you received your PDF regarding the practice. So anyway, today evening we have that session. We will complete those questions, the practice ones. Now please try to do that. If you are not, because I want you to try. Then only you will understand the, you know, the whole scenario. Okay. So yeah, today's topics are this, guys. Today I want to introduce one reasoning topic. Okay, that is number series. Okay, and profit and loss, which is the extension of percentages, and the other one would be simple interest and compound interest. Okay, we need to do all these. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, Rishvik, Rushvik, yeah, whatever. Yeah, we will try to do that. Please try to message in the WhatsApp group. So they'll let you know. Our team will let you know regarding that. Okay. Yes, guys. So yeah, in couple of minutes we will start, in 2 to 3 minutes time. So meanwhile, guys, tell me, what is 9 square? Okay, today I would like to tell about a 9 table, which is a interesting table, 81. Okay, 9 ones are 9. 9 twos are 18. 9 threes are, everybody know these things, but you are going to learn one a new thing. 9 fours are 36. 9 fives are 45. Yes or no? What is 9 sixes are 54. 9 sevens are 63. 9 eights are 72. 9 nines are 81. 9 tens are 90. If you take all these numbers, the sum of the digit, you will get 9 only. Yes or no? Are you getting 9? Yeah, yeah. There are so many ways to handle the situation, because 0 plus 9 is 9. 1 plus 8 is 9. 2 plus 7 is 9. 3 plus 6 is 9. 4 plus 5 is 9. 9 plus 0 is 9. 8 plus 1 is 9. 7 plus 2 is 9. 6 plus 3 is 9. 5 plus 4 is 9. If you closely observe, 9 ones are 9, I can write 09. 9 tens are 90, reverse of this number only. 9 twos are 18. 9 nines are 81, reverse of 18 only. Reverse of 27 only 72. Reverse of 36 only 63. Reverse of 45 only 54. We don't realize, okay, this is the thing happening. Are you observed anything, anywhere, anybody observed these logics? Yeah, great. Okay, yeah, and you know, you can write directly, you can write all the natural numbers, like zero is not a whole numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you know, 6, 7, 8, 9. Again, if you start from here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this will give you 9 table. Okay, this will give you 9 table. Yeah, you might have observed in long back. Okay. So yeah, so let's get started. Guys, quickly, if you want to good at a numbered series, first I want you to know squares from 1 to 30. Could you please tell me what is 29 square? Problem comes. Answer will come lately now. Because 29 square, yeah. If I ask 25 square, everybody will tell. Yeah, now you might have write the floating of answers. What is 25 square? Yeah, a lot of people will answer 625. If I ask 29, problem used to come. What is 29 square? 841. 29 square is what? 841. What is 28 square? Problem again come. If I ask 15, everybody will tell. Yeah, what is 15 square? 15 square, everybody will answer. 225. Guys, please understand this point. The answers which known by everybody will not come in your exams. People who don't know the things, they'll try to give in the exams. Okay? Yeah. Because, you know, if the series is like this. Guys, tell me. What is the next number? What would be the next number? Is my series is right? Yeah, pretty much right. Yeah, so what would be the next number? Yeah, the next number has to be what? 63. So what is the logic we are writing here? Can I say this is 9 cube minus 1? This is 8 cube minus 1. This is what? 7 cube minus 1. This is what? 6 cube minus 1. This is what? 5 cube minus 1. So next has to be 4 cube minus 1. 4 cube is what? 64. Minus 1 is what? 63. Yes or no? Minus 1 would be what here? 63. Okay. So the point is, you know, if you want to good at number series, a few tips and tricks here. You should know squares. You should know cubes. You should know powers of at least 3, 4, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Okay. And you should good with calculating the difference between the numbers. Okay. You should be good at calculating the difference between the numbers. If that is done, guys, trust me, 70% of the questions, if you calculate the difference, you can get your job. Okay. Yeah, guys, tell me what is the answer for this question? (51, 57, 69, 84) (102, 108) Yeah. Okay. So before going to the answer, yeah. But everybody is doing wrong. Okay. Guys, tell me, what is the first difference here? Everybody? What is the first difference? Everyone. The first difference is 6. Next difference is what, ma? 12. Next difference is what? 15. Okay. People who are saying 108. People who are saying 108, I need to add how much? Could you please tell me this? People who are saying 108, 99, 24. Okay, why should I add 24? Because they don't have any logic for 24. Don't say multiples of 6. 15 is not a multiple of 6. Please mind the gap. Yeah, 84 plus 30. 114. Okay. Yeah, multiples of 3. Okay, people will say multiples of 3. Can I write this as 6? 3 2s are 6. Can I write this as 3 4s are? Can I write this as 3 5s are? So, a lot of people will write 3 6s are 18. So, 84 plus 18, they'll write 102. How much is this? 84 plus 18. They'll write 102. Yes or no? 102. So, again, why you are writing multiples of 3? You know, this is 3 2s are, 3 4s are, 3 5s are, 3 6s are. Where gone 3 into 3? 3 into 3, 9 should be there, no? You can talk about prime numbers also. If it is 3 into 3, I mean, here the difference is 9, then your logic would be right. Because 2, 3, 5, next I need to multiply, 3 7s are 21. So 84 plus 21. Again, the numbers will change. That is a different scenario. Nobody got the correct answer as of now. Okay, 114. Why 114? Logic. I want the logic. I don't want the answers. 114. Could you please tell me why 114? Yes. Now one answer is coming up. Yeah. You know, 6 double 12. You know, it means here it has to be 12 double 24, no? Then your logic would be correct. So don't say 15 double 30. Okay, so that's the wrong observation. Very good. One fellow got it, which is Rajeshwar Reddy got 96. That's appreciated. Rajeshwar, could you please tell me the logic? Yes. Abdul also got the logic. So the logic is sum of the digits. So 6 here, here 6 is nothing but what? Yeah, so here 6 is nothing but what? 5 plus 1, 6. Here 12 is nothing but 5 plus 7. 15 is nothing but 6 plus 9. So it has to be 12 because sum of the digits 8 plus 4. So 84 plus 12 is going to be what? 96. You know, that's what I used to say always. This is not to recruit, to eliminate. Okay, guys, I understand, you know, people who don't know this particular logic, because, you know, out of, you know, almost 500 students, you know, one or two students got the logic, which means you need to understand, guys, you need to understand there are few questions you can avoid it, but, you know, one of the two persons will do and, you know, they will ahead of you. Okay, they will ahead of you. So, guys, if you want to good at number series, you should thorough with the patterns. Okay, the only way to good in number series is you need to have a good practice. Guys, tell me if this is a series, what could be your answer? Tell me. What is the next number? Quick. The moment you saw these numbers, your mind should think about, yeah, there is a big increment. When there is a big increment, you might think about squares, you might think about cubes, you might think about, you know, multiplication thing. Okay, the answer is going to be what? 216. Why 216? These are cubes. 1 cube, 2 cube, 3 cube, you know, 4 cube, 5 cube sort of things. Okay, you know, they will not give the question directly like this. You know, they'll twist you. They'll give questions in this way. Okay. Yeah, you know, because you know this question, everybody will answer this question. Are you getting my point? If you don't know this question, because they'll not give, no? So first series is this, the next series is this. Because in the exams, they'll give directly this question. Yeah, you should thorough with this. Yeah, everybody know the answer. Answer is, you know, 215. Answer is what here? 215. If the question is like this, could you please tell me what would be the answer? Yeah. Very good. See, guys, the point here is, you know, because they'll not give this example, they'll give directly this. Whenever there is a big increment, you know, they are almost near to all cubes. 5 cube plus 5, you know, 4 cube plus 4. This is what? 3 cube plus 3. This is what? 2 cube plus 2. This is what? 1 cube plus 1. So answer would be 6 cube plus 6. So the answer is what? 222. Yes or no? So guys, the point is this, n cube plus n is the logic. Okay, this is n cube minus 1 is the logic. This is what? N cube. Okay, so guys, you know, it may be n cube plus 1 logic. It may be n cube minus 1 logic. It may be n cube, you know, prime number logic. You know, you don't know, because number series have, you know, they have feasibility that they can give you questions like anything. Okay, so I would like to solve, you know, few questions now. Okay, I want you to crack all these questions. So these are previous ones, okay, which I gathered, okay, in so many competitive examinations regarding all MNC companies. So I want you to know all these questions. So quickly tell me, what is the answer for this question? So guys, please observe the things. The number is increment. There is a lot of increment. Okay, 31 and 129, you know, there is a huge increment. Almost, if you closely look at there, almost how many times it is there? You know, it is almost 4 times. This is almost 3 times. Okay. This is also almost 3 times, but here already we are getting a pattern. So this is almost 4 times. This is almost 3 times because 9 3 is 27. So this is almost 2 times. This is almost 1 time, which means something is there. Okay, so figure it out and tell me the answer. Okay, a lot of people are getting their answers. Yeah, firstly, who told me the answer? So let me check with him. Yeah, Shiva Sai got the answer. Yugender, maybe you also got the answer, but you know, Sai, please tell me the answer, Sai. Yeah, I know you have written the code there. Yeah, Pratap also got the code. Yes. Yes, Sharat got the answer. Okay, Ritvik, a lot of people, now people are getting their answers. Good. Yes. So people who are getting the answer is 651. They are absolutely right. 651. Very good. 651. Okay. What is the logic? You know, 31, you know, we just now talked about, you know, it's almost four times because 30 into 4 will be 120. So 124. So can I say this is going to be 4 times 31 into 4. So extra, how much you have here? Please tell me, please answer my question. So 31 into 4 plus extra, how much you have here? 5 you have. So here we observed extra, we have, you know, it's almost 3 times. So extra, how much we had, Nana, here? So extra, we had 4. Yes or no? So can I say, now we find out one logic, into 2. So this is what? Plus 3. This is what? Into 1. Okay. This is what? Into 1 plus 2. So your answer must be what? Into? Yeah. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So I need to multiply with 5. But I need to add how much here? 6. Okay. I need to add how much here? Yes. Some people will get confused, you know. If you don't have 4 here, you can use a logic of prime number logic. But you have 4 here, no? So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, natural number. So next number used to come as what? 129 into 5 plus 6. So the answer is what? 651. So done with this, everybody? Done with this, everybody? Okay, let's go to the next question. Kindly reply in the live chat. Say yes, yes, yes. We'll go to the next question. Everybody. Please try to solve this question. Very easy. I want to see who is going to give the correct answer first. Yeah, 8, 4, 4, 6, 12. So observe the first observation is important. Is there anything? Are you getting anything? Very good. Sharat got the answer. Good, Sharat. Chaitanya got the answer. Great. Sanjay, please check your answer. Amrita, good. Vivek, check your answer. Okay. Nitisha, check your answer. Rakesh, right. Deepika, right. Prasanna, good. Appreciated. Yeah, most of the persons are getting the answers. Arjun, good. Sai, please check out your answer. Yugender, no, that's the wrong one. Ritvik, good. Vivek, correct answer. Lakshmi Priya, no. Shiva, no. Yeah. Gautam, good. Okay. So answer for this question is, okay. Guys, you know, here it's 2 times. Here it is 1 time. Yes or no? If you observed this, so because series means, you know, you should have logic from beginning to ending. That's the prerequisite. Okay, Saket, you are right. Guys, tell me, here it is 1, here it is 2. You know, can I say here it may be 1.5? So this is a 0.5 logic. Can I say 8 into 0.5 only 4? So 4 into 1.5, are you getting 6? Please clarify this first. 4 into 1.5, are you getting 6? Yes or no? So into 0.5, into 1, into 1.5, into 2. So next has to be into everybody. Into what? 2.5. Yes or no? 2.5. So 12, 2 is a 24. 12 half 6. 24 plus 6 is going to be what? 24 plus 6 is going to be what? 30 as your answer. Okay. So that's complete our solution. Let's go to the next series. Yes, guys, quick. Quick. Very good, very good. People are coming up with their answers. Great. Yes, guys, what is the answer? Very good. Everybody is getting, which is a similar logic. Yes or no? Guys, so you need to observe one thing. I mean, this is not the big observation. This is not the big observation, guys. Our previous question is 8, 4, 4, 6, 12 dash. Guys, whenever there is a 0.5 logic, okay, your second and third numbers are same. Yes or no? Because if we can't recognize here because we are not aware of the numbers. But if you closely observe, this is into 2 only. Because 2 2s are 4, 0.25 into 2 is 5. Okay, we can observe here this is into 1, and we can observe here this is into 0.5. So here obviously into 1.5, because we may not recognize this, but we can recognize into 1.5, into 1.5, this is into 2. So next has to be into 2.5. If you do into 2.5, you will get 11.25 as your answer. People who got 11.25, they are absolutely right. So my advice, whenever you are getting, two numbers, the same numbers, okay, the logic would be, into 0.5. So always there is an increment of 0.5. Okay, always there is an increment of 0.5. So that's complete our solution. Let's go to the next question. Quick. 4, 2, 11, 37, 153. See, the number is increasing, See, that's, I want you to observe the things from 37 to 153. Almost, look at there. If I take 5 times, it may exceed that. If I take 4 times, please think about it. Okay, so 11 and 37, almost 3 times. 4 and 11, almost 2 times. 2 and 4. Yes, guys. Very good. Rakesh got the answer. Okay. Yes, guys. What could be the answer? 771. 771. Okay. Guys, look at here. Can I say this is 11 into 3, 33 plus 4 only 37? So 37 into 4 plus what here? 5. So 37 into 4 plus 5. So can I say this is 4 into 2 plus 3, 4, 2 is 8 plus 3 only 11. So can I say this going to be what? Into 1 plus 2. So you can see a pattern. Into 1, into 2, into 3, into 4, it has to be into 5. So plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, it has to be plus 6. So 153 into 5, okay? So plus 6. So the answer is going to be what? 771. People who got 771, so that's complete your solution. Okay, that's complete your solution. Let's go to the next two questions. So we have so many questions, but we need to solve the other questions. So you can, anyway, you can get in practice sheet. If you want, today I'll post in my LinkedIn ID, two or three nice logical ones, nice series. Yeah. Yes, guys. What is the answer for this? Quickly. So we have more 4 minutes, as many questions as we can, could anybody tell me the logic? Yeah, people are getting their answers, but could anybody tell me the logic? 62, 64, prime number. All these are prime numbers, or difference is a prime number? Is the difference is a prime number? Yeah. What is the first difference? Quick. Yeah, what is the first difference? 5. Okay. What is the next difference? 5. 7. Okay, so the next would be 11. So the next would be 13. So, and the next would be 17. So 45 plus 17. 45 plus 17, answer 62. Okay, that's complete your solution. Next question. Yeah, 4, 3, 4.5, 8.75. Okay, 20. Okay, yeah. Okay. Yes, a lot of people are, Manan, what's his name, man? The first one who posted me the answer, Sharath. Is it Sharath? You only posted. Yeah. Okay. Yes. Yeah. So guys, the answer is 53. People who got 53, they might know the logic. So, guys, look at here. 4 into 0.5 is what, Nana? 4 into 0.5. Okay. 4 into 0.5 is what? 2. Plus 1 only 3. Then only this number used to come. Next. 3 into 1 plus 1.5. 3 into 1 is what? 3 plus 1.5 will give you 4.5. Next, 4.5 into, okay, 4.5 into 0.5 into 1. So next 1.5. So, but I need to add how much here? Plus 2. So always there is an increment of 0.5 and he is adding plus 1. 3 into 1 and he is adding 1.5. 4.5 into 1.5 plus 2. Are you getting 8.75? You will get 8.75. So 8.75 into 2 plus 2.5. You will get your answer as 20. So next would be 20 into 3. Is it 20 into 3 only? Sorry, 20 into 2.5 plus 3. 20 into 2.5. 22 is a 40. Half of 20 is 10. So that is 50. And you need to add plus 3. So answer for this question is what? 53. Okay. Answer for this question is what? Here, 53. 53 is going to be the answer. Okay. That's complete our solution. So quickly, I want to talk about in 5 minutes. Guys, if you want, you know, you can take a screenshot of these series and you can try there. You can try. Yeah, please take a screenshot. Anyway, you will get 4 to 5 questions in your practice sheet also. Those are the different ones. If you want, I can discuss the, if I get time, I can discuss in the afternoon session of these questions. Take a screenshot and say yes in the live chat. Yeah. Okay, everybody, please try to take a screenshot and, you know, please practice after the session. Guys, tell me, I have a few more series, which is a later series, because quickly in 5 minutes, I want to finish this. Please try to answer this series, Nana. What would be the answer for this question? Guys, you know, the only mantra to get your answers in series, okay? You should know the place positions. If you know the place positions, the job would be very easy. Okay. Yeah. If you know the place positions, the job would be very easy. So this is the first letter, fourth letter, ninth letter, 16th letter, 25th letter. So you might have understood. So what are these numbers? These numbers are squares. We know J is a 10th letter, but I can write this number as 36 also. Why I'm writing 36? Because 26 plus 10. Are you getting it? So 26 plus 10. So next number would be what? 49. How should I write 49? We have only 26 alphabets, no? So can I write 49 as 26 plus 23? So what is 23rd letter? W. So answer for this question is what? W. Okay. Answer for this question is what? W. Okay. Yeah. So if you have questions like this, could you please tell me the answer? Trust me, if you know the place positions, you can get your answer very easily. If you don't know the place positions, the job will be so difficult. Yeah, anybody? Okay, for you, I am going to write the place values. First letter, third letter, sixth letter, 11th letter, 18th letter. You know, it should be in your mind. So the job would be easy. Okay, could anybody tell me the logic? People are getting C and D. C and D, both answers people are getting here. Okay. Could you tell me? Okay. Forget about the answer. Could you tell me what is the difference here? Please tell me the difference. The difference here is 2. The difference here is 3. The difference here is 5. The difference here is 7. 2, 3, 5, 7 are what? Yeah. 2, 3, 5, 7 are what here? Prime numbers. So what would be the next prime number? 11. Yes or no? So 28 plus 11 is what? 28 plus 11. Can I say that's going to be? Sorry, 18 plus 11. 18 plus 11. So 18 plus 11 is what? 29. So 29, I can split it as what? 26 plus 3. So what is the third letter? C. People who are getting C, they're absolutely fantastic. Okay. Could you please answer this? Yeah, definitely out of 600 art students, you know, few definitely know all the three questions answers. Already, you know, Shivasri is saying, yes, you know, but the problem is only maybe 100 students know this, or maybe 50 students know this. Yeah, but after this session, because these are popular ones, in so many exams, these questions are going to be pop up. Yeah. Yeah, that's already we discussed now how to remember the shortcuts for alphabets. Okay, if I get a time, I'll discuss in the afternoon, I mean today's evening session, how to remember place values easily. Okay, yeah, guys, you know, this is your months, January, February, March, April, May, June, July. So this is what? Months. Okay, so what would be the next month's first letter? So what would be the answer? Answer is going to be what here? August. So these are weekdays, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And this is going to be, okay. Yeah, I'll do it today. Okay. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And this is going to be what? Saturday. So this is what, Nana? Numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay. 7, you know, please remember this. Guys, if you don't know these questions, definitely we might writing place values like 10, 6, 13, 1, 13, 10, 10. You know, we don't find any logic. So again, you know, we will end up, you know, answering the wrong answer. Okay. So please remember these numbers. If you don't find any logic in between them, you know, please go for general approach. Try to think about, you know, in a general way. Okay. So let's discuss profit and loss. Okay, so few basic questions. I brought one article for 1 rupee. I sold it for 2 rupees. So what is the profit, ma? It's a baby. Yeah. Everybody know this. Yeah, what is the profit? 1 rupee. What is the profit percentage? Yeah, what is the profit percentage? Fantastic. What is the profit percentage here? 100% or 50%. Again, few people are doing it wrong. Yeah, 100%. Okay. profit percentage. Yeah, 100%. Guys, tell me, I brought one article for 7 rupees, sold it for 6 rupees. Profit or loss? First tell me, profit or loss? Everybody know this. Just 5 minutes, I'll discuss basics. Loss. Tell me directly how much percent loss. I don't want how many rupees loss. I want how much percent loss. Yes. Again, 100%. 10%. Yeah, few people are doing great job. Yeah. So the answer for this question is what? 14.28% loss. Okay. So I am going to discuss here 2 points. Can I say your cost price is more than your selling price? You are in profit or loss, Nana? Your cost price is more than your selling price. Your cost price is more than selling price. You will be in where? Loss. Loss. Yes or no? Your selling price is more than cost price. Definitely you are in. Yeah, definitely you are in where? Definitely you will be in profit. Definitely you will be in profit. In this scenario, you will get what? Loss. Guys, that yesterday I discussed, whenever come across this symbol, something should be in the numerator and something should be in the denominator into 100. Just I am adding profit percentage. In profit percentage, what I will compare? Profit. What is your profit in the first question? 1. I need to compare with cost price or selling price. That is the prerequisite. If you know this, you can answer any question. Always remember, profit or loss is always calculated only on cost price, not on selling price. Selling price, you don't suppose to write in the denominator. You always compare with cost price. What is your cost price? 1. So that's why you will end up with saying answer is what? 100%. So can I conclude? Don't remember these formulas. Profit by cost price into 100. I can write profit as, you know, selling price minus cost price by cost price into 100. You know, please don't. Yeah, you should have an idea, but don't do with these formulas. Okay. Yeah. So, you know, you should have in your mind, we can orally, we can do it. Okay. How about last percentage? Percentage again, something should be in the numerator and something should be in the denominator into 100. Last percentage. I am comparing what? Loss. 7 rupees, 6 rupees. How much loss you are getting? 1 rupee. Tell me, loss percentage is calculated on where? Profit, cost price or selling price? Loss percentage. Don't get confused. Whether it is profit percentage or loss percentage is always calculated only on cost price. That's the important point. Okay? Profit percentage or loss percentage is always calculated only on cost price. Okay? Cost price. So 1 by, what is your cost price? Your CP is 7 rupees. So 1 by 7. That's why you should know all the reciprocal values. So 1 by 7 is what? 14.28%. 1 by 7 is what here? 14.28%. Okay, 14.28%. Okay, so if you want, you know, profit is equals to selling price minus cost price. Loss is equals to cost price minus selling price. Profit percentage is equals to profit by cost price into 100. Loss percentage is equals to loss by cost price into 100. Okay. Profit percentage, I can write one more funda. Profit is nothing but what? SP minus CP by CP into 100. Okay. So the loss percentage would be what? CP minus SP by again CP into 100. Okay. If you want, you can note down all the formulas. Sometimes SP will be given, loss percentage is given. You need to figure it out cost price by using, you can rearrange this situation and you can get your answer. But I don't prefer all these formula based ones. Okay. Yeah. Guys, please write down a question. By selling an article for rupees, by selling an article for rupees. Okay. By selling an article for rupees, 8,100. By selling an article for rupees 8,100. Okay, 8,100. Navin Polishetty. Navin Polishetty gets a loss of 10%. Okay, by selling an article for rupees 8,100, Navin Polishetty is getting a loss of 10%. What is the cost price? I know it's a very easy one. Yeah, I know it's a very easy one, but again, people do mistakes here. You know, people will write so many wrong answers. I'll tell all the answers. Yeah, but most of people are getting it right. That appreciated. Yeah. Yes. Okay. People who got first, they will write one answer, you know, which is 8,900 and this. People write their one answer as this. The other people will write 7,000 and something. Anybody got 7,000 and something? Please tell me your answer, which is 8,100 minus 810. You will get one answer. Yeah, you will get one answer. 8,290. Okay, 8,290. Okay, 8,290. You will get the other answer. Guys, please ask yourself a question. People who are getting this answer, this is your selling price. Okay, when this is your selling price, you know, you are in loss. Your cost price should be more than your selling price, no? Yes or no? Then only you will be in loss, right? Then how you are getting this answer? Are you getting my point? Your cost price has to be more than, yeah, your cost price has to be what? More than your selling price, then only you will be in loss. So this is ruled out. Yeah. Inkoka batch untaru. I mean, they what? Wallet tapugal basically, they don't have a clarity. They'll calculate 10% of this number neatly, 810 they'll get, and they'll directly add 10% takkundi kada, you know, they will add this. So that's why they'll end up with 8,190. Guys, always remember, don't calculate your profit percentage or loss percentage on SP. You have to calculate on what? CP. Do you have CP in the question? No, right? Then on what basis you are going to calculate? Okay, yeah, the answer for this question is what? 9,000. How it is 9,000? I want to discuss this only one point. Listen carefully. Okay, guys, this is your option. When you brought it, this is what? Always 100%. Always remember, cost price is 100%. Please bear me for 2 to 3 minutes because this is important. Lot of people might know this, so I want to talk about this. So your cost price is always what percent? 100%. You brought it. But when the time you are selling it, you know, you are getting a loss of 10%. You are getting a loss of what percent? 10%, which means the customer will pay only this price. You brought it for 100 and you are getting a loss of 10%. So the customer paid how much percent? Everybody tell me in the live chat. The customer paid how much percent? Tell me the percent. Okay, the customer paid how much percent? 90%. Yes or no? So 90% is what your selling price. 90% is what your selling price. In the question, selling price was given. 90% equals to what? 8,100. Then 100% is equals to how much? Zero, zero cancel. Nine ones are, nine nines are, and is zero. 1% is 90, then 100% is what? 9,000. Then 100% is going to be what here? 9,000. SRO, 100% is going to be what here? 9,000 is going to be your answer. Okay, 9,000 is going to be your answer. Guys, always remember, the moment you saw loss, subtract from 100, you will get 90. Let's say there is a loss of 20%. When your selling price will become what? 80%. When there is a loss of 30%, your selling price will become what? 70%. Okay, let's say there is a profit of 10%. Tell me what will become your selling price? Yes, your selling price will become what? Okay. Yeah, that will help Krishna definitely. 110%. Whenever you have a profit, it is always more than 100. Whenever you have a loss, this is always less than 100. Okay, always less than 100 when you are in loss. Okay, so we will go ahead and, you know, try to solve the question. So tell me what would be the answer for this question. Quick. So guys, here, look at here. The point here is cost price and selling price ratio was given 14 is to 13. Okay, 14 is to 13. Your cost price is 14, selling price is 13. Okay. Yeah. So guys, what is the difference here, Nana? One is the difference. And you know, you are going to compare with what? You are going to compare with what? You are going to compare with the cost price into 100. 1 by 14. Lot of people think that we don't know 1 by 14. But you know 1 by 7, no? 1 by 7 is 14.28. Half of 1 by 7 only, you will get 1 by 14, right? So half of 14.28. So the answer is what? 7.14. People who got 7.14, they are absolutely right. Okay, 7.14 is going to be your answer. Okay, next question.
For rotor slots and tailor slots.
Quickly, we need to solve. A man lost 25% by selling a horse at rupees 1500. What percent shall he gain or loss by selling the horses at 2500? Simple. He is getting a loss of 25% when he's selling at 1500. So we need to calculate the. Yes, very, very easy ones. Yeah, what is the answer? 25%. Okay, out of curiosity, I'm asking, can anybody tell me what is the cost price of the horse? Yeah, we don't need that. Yeah. Okay, guys, you know, whenever you are getting a loss, tell me when 25% loss, what is your selling price? Tell me first, tell me this. When you are 25% loss, because cost price is always 100%. When 25% loss means 100 minus 25, so 75%. So 75% is 1500. Okay, when you are selling it for 2500, so how much this? Okay, yeah, how much is this is going to be? So is you are getting this as 125? Is this 125%? So when the cost price is always 100%, so how much more this? 25%, that's it. So answer for this question is what? 25% is going to be our answer. Okay, 25% is going to be our answer. Let's say when you are selling it for 2200, can anybody tell me what is your profit percentage? I mean, like the same question. Yeah, if you are smart enough, you will tell me because just now you only told me that the 100% is what? 2000, no? When it is 2000, 200 extra means what? 110%, because 10% extra. Yes or no? Because on 200, 10% would be what? 200. On 2000, 1000 would be what? 200. Yes or no? Okay, let me change this number. You need to tell me the directly how much extra. Okay, let's take this is 2100. 2100. Answer? Very good. 5%. Fantastic. Let's say this number is 2050. Then what would be your answer? Then what would be your answer? 2.5. Fantastic. Fantastic. Let's say the value is 2400. Answer? 2400. 400 is what? 20%. Very good. Appreciated. Appreciated. Let's say, okay. Okay, I hope you are getting it. Great. So guys, you know, this is a popular model. This is so many times in so many exams, you know, these types of questions you can see. So many exams. Yeah. Very basic one. Very basic one. Okay. First, tell me, are you getting profit or loss by this particular question? Profit or loss? Gain only? Okay. Guys, you know, first let me do it in a simple manner. Okay. 12 CP is equals to 9 SP. Okay, CP by SP is equals to 9 by 12. You brought it for 9 rupees, you are selling it for 12 rupees. Are you getting profit or loss? Okay, you will get profit of 3 rupees. I want profit percentage. So 3 by 9 into 100. So the answer for this question is what? 33.33%. People who got 25, they'll write in the denominator 12. Guys, you need to understand what to write in the numerator, what to write in the denominator. See, I don't want to put any more discussion here because everyone might understood this simple scenario. Okay, if we have time, we can experiment, but I don't have time. So, you know, just follow this way or orally also we can do it by looking at the question. Okay, if I get time, I'll discuss, I'll take 5 minutes time in the evening. I'll discuss elaborately. I'll tell you regarding this particular question. So answer for this question is what? 33.33. Yeah, what is the answer for this question? Quick. Okay. Yes, guys, what is the answer? Yeah. Okay, guys, you know, very simple question, you know, a profit obtained by selling a goods at 425 is equals to the loss obtained by selling the same goods for 355. Guys, can I conclude, you know, directly these two options will get eliminated because your cost price has to be in between 425 and 355, no? Yes or no? In between these two numbers. So two options got eliminated. Now there is a probability of 50% chance to get your answer right. Yes or no? But look at here. If the cost price is 360, okay, when you sold it for 355, you will get a loss of 5 rupees. When you sold it for 425, you will get a loss of, you will get a profit of 65 rupees. Do you think this is a choice? No, this is the wrong one. So eliminated. Your answer is 390. Okay, so 390, half 390. Could you please tell me 390 to 355? What is the difference? Everybody, please tell me. What is the difference here? Yeah. Yeah, the difference is what? The difference here is what? 35. Okay, 425. What is the difference here? Okay, equal they are saying. Okay, this is not two times. Okay, equal. So is the difference is also same 35? So, yeah. So you got it? Yes or no? So the answer is what? D. But I want to tell you, I want to add one more point here. Guys, look at here. You know, let me use the concept of, can I say in this question, they are saying profit is equals to loss, agree? Profit is nothing but SP minus CP. Loss is nothing but CP minus SP. Yes or no? In two cases, SP is given. In the first case, SP is 425. In the next case, SP is what, Nana? 355. So if you rearrange the situation, okay, so this value minus 365, so I have CP, here I have a CP. So if I rearrange this, I'll get 425 plus 355 is equals to only 2 CP. So that is nothing but CP is nothing but 425 plus 355 divided by 2, nothing but average of these two numbers. Yes or no? Yeah, average of those two numbers, agree? Yeah, whatever may be the answer, you know, I want you to observe the things. Okay, I want you to observe the things. Whenever there is a profit is equals to loss, so 2 CP used to come. Whenever you will, they'll definitely give 2 SPs. So directly calculate the average of those two numbers, you can get your answer. Okay, what is the answer for this question? A man sold two horses for 6750H. He sold one at a loss of 15%, the other at a gain of 15%. So find the Yeah, find the loss or gain percentage. Yeah. No gain, no loss. Very good. No gain, no loss. Very good. Very good. So answer for this question is what? No gain, no loss. Nice. People who are getting no gain, no loss, they are absolutely blunder. Okay, they are absolutely blunder. Yeah. No gain, no loss is a wrong answer. I know when no gain, no loss used to come, you know, when the cost price of two horses is same, then your answer would be what? No gain, no loss. Okay, your answer is going to be what? No gain, no loss. Guys, you know, let me explain you quickly. Okay, let's say there is a horse. He sold it for the cost price of the horse is going to be, every horse is 100. Okay, so let's say this is CP1 and this is CP2. Okay, let's say first horse and the second horse. The profit percentage is 10%. So the selling price would be 110. And the last percentage is what? 10%. The selling price would be again 90. You brought it for 200 and you are selling it is also for 200. So in this scenario, you will get a no profit, no loss case. Okay, no profit, no loss case. Okay, guys, you know, for these kind of questions, you know, there is a direct shortcut. But the point is this, when the selling price of two articles are same, that's the prerequisite. So in this case, always you will get a loss of X square by 100%. What do you mean by X? Profit or loss percentage. Okay, profit or loss percentage, X square. Okay, what is 15 square? 225 by 100. So the answer is 2.25% of loss. So people who got option C, they are absolutely right. Okay. Yeah, when CP is same, when only cost price is same, there is a no profit, no loss. When selling price is same and same profit percentage, same loss percentage, always you will be in loss. Okay, so please remember this formula, always you will be in loss. Condition is what? SP1 should be equals to SP2. Okay, SP1 should be equals to SP2 and profit percentage has to be equals to loss percentage. Then directly formula is what? Okay, in this scenario, always you will get a loss. You will never get a gain. Maybe if the selling prices of two horses are different, profit and loss percentage was different, maybe you will get a gain. Okay, but in this special case, always you will get a loss only. And the loss is what? X square by 100. And the loss is what here? X square by 100. So next one. Quickly, I want you to solve it. Quick. Okay, guys, what is the answer? Anybody got the answer? Okay. Okay, B means 500. Okay, D means what? D means 550. Okay. Okay. Guys, you know, I brought two books for 950. I sold one at a loss of 20%, the other at a gain of 10%. Then I found that each book was sold at the same price. Okay, which means, can I conclude? My selling price of two articles were same. Yes or no? Okay, so answer for this question, you know, we will see. So I want the what? The cost price of the cost yearbook. So out of 950, okay, out of 950, let's say the first article cost price is X. So can I say the next one would be 950 minus X? So this is my CP2. Agree? So first article sold at what percent loss? 20%. So can I say when it is 20% loss, can I say this is 80% of X only? My selling price would be? There is a gain of 10%. Can I say this is 110% of 950 minus X? Agree? Can I say these two are equal? They are only saying no. I found that both books are sold at the same price. So my percentage symbol gone, zero will get cancelled. Can I say 8X is equals to 11 into 950 minus 11X. So 11 go to this side. So 19X is equals to 11 into 950, which means 19 how many times this particular value? So 50 times. So can I say X is nothing but 550? When X is 550, okay, when X is 550, so this would be what? 400. Together you are getting 950. Yes. So the cost price of the first article is what? 550. The cost price of the second article is going to be what? 400. So the question is this now, you know, the cost price of first article is what here? 550. So the question is what? What is the costlier book of cost price? So that will give you what? Your answer is what? 550. Okay. 550. Yes. Okay. 550. Yeah, you can do by verification. Okay, because the total price is 950. No? What is half of 950? What is half of 950? Anybody in the live chat? Half of 950. Half of 950. Yeah, 475. Okay, 475. So definitely your answer has to be more than 475. Yes or no? Your answer has to be more than 475. So because you want a costlier book, it should not be equal. So it should be more than 475. So with that, option A and option C will get eliminated. Yes or no? Option A and option C will get eliminated. If you check the remaining two, let's say if you assume one book price is 500, so other book will become 450. Yes or no? And you need to check if the cost price is this, when there is a 10% loss. So you will definitely sold it for what? 450. Then here, if you have, 20% loss, no? So 20% loss means what? So 20% loss means 100. So you will sold it for 400. Okay. And here, 10% gain, which means you need to add 45 to this value. Are you getting these two values are equal? No. Which essentially you can get your answer. But I'm not interested in these two methods. I am interested in one more method. Look at here. Yeah. That's what I'm telling Mukund. Listen here. Can I say I brought two books for 950? It's not a shortcut, just an observation. Instead of taking one variable, let me take two variables. Okay. Can I write, let's say this is my cost price one, this is my cost price two. Okay. Guys, whenever this is a cost price one and this is cost price two, guys, can I conclude? First article is sold at 20% loss. So can I say this is 8X and this would be 11X? Agree? Because in your mind, 80% of X, which is equals to 110% of Y. I am canceling percentage zero in my mind. Is this clear? Sorry, this is Y. Is this clear? Is this point clear? Yes or no? Please reply here so that you will understand it. Okay. So from this, can I write X by Y is equals to 11 by 8? Agree? X by Y is equals to 11 by 8? Agree? Guys, so definitely I can say my costlier book is X only, no? Because it is 11 parts. This is what? 8 parts. Okay. So your answer is definitely a multiple of 11. How many options you have multiple of 11 as your answer? Only one option. So that's how you can get your answer. Understood my logic? Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
because x by y is you are getting 11. Again, you know, you can solve this. You know, guys, look at here. You can take like this, because 11 and 8 total, how many parts? 19 parts. When 19 parts is 950, can I write one part is 50? Then 11 parts would be 11 into 50. Answer is 550. That's a different case. But without calculating this also, I can do this. Again, there is a different case to use to come. Let's say the one more option is 660. If you have two options which are multiples of 6, again, you have to go back to this method and you have to do it. So it's always, guys, always in aptitude, how we are reacting according to the situation. That's the most important factor here. Okay, so this is all situation based problems. How we are reacting to that question is most important. Okay, so done with this. Yeah. Yes, guys, what is the answer for this question? A shopkeeper claims to sell sugar at a cost price, but he uses a false weight and he is getting 25% profit. How much? Yeah, tell me. This is also a popular one in so many exams. This fault balance question used to come. Yes. Okay. There are so many shortcuts for this also, but I don't prefer that, because if you understood the basic root cause of this particular question, you know, a shopkeeper claims to sell sugar at a cost price. So first, this is important point, but he uses a false weight, but nobody will sell their goods at cost price. If I brought it for 100, do you think I'm selling it for 100? No, I will say 200, because you will bargain. No, that's why I will say double the price. You might have encountered this in so many. So guys, look at here. So the first point is the cost price, and nobody will sell it cost price, because of he promised that I am selling the goods at cost price. He is not giving 1 kg. Instead of 1 kg, he is giving something else. Okay, guys, 1 kg is equals to how many grams? 1 kg is equals to 1000 grams, right? 1 gram, let's assume 1 gram price is 1 rupee, to better understanding. Okay, let's say this is a pan, or this is an electrical, you know, weighing machine. So already I manipulated the machine in such a way. So let me pour sugar here. Let me pour sugar. You know, I am pouring the sugar. Okay, I am pouring the sugar. Okay, I am pouring the sugar. Okay, when I am pouring the sugar, when it is reaching at a point, okay, at some value, you know, you are getting 25% profit. Okay, 25% profit. Let's say, let me pour 800 grams here. Okay, if I pour 800, guys, can I say directly the 1000 is eliminated? Directly 1000 is eliminated. If he is giving 1000 grams, you know, that is not going to be possible. So less than 1000 only he need to give us. Yes or no? Okay. If I pour 100, if 1 gram is equals to 1 rupee, you know, but the weighing machine shows how many? 1000 grams, which means you have to pay 1000 rupees, no? Yes or no? You have to pay 1000 rupees, but he is giving a worth of what? 800 rupees only. He is giving a worth of what? 800 rupees only. Are you getting my point? He is giving a worth of what? 800 rupees only. When he is giving a worth of 800 rupees, okay, 800 rupees. So guys, how much profit he used to get here? In this scenario, he'll get 200 rupees as a profit. But what is his cost price? His cost price is 800 into 100. So 200 by 800, which is 1 by 4. 1 by 4 means 25% only, no? So it is verified by using option 1. Yes or no? Is it 20% or 25%? 25% only, no? 25 only, right? Yeah, 25. Okay, 25. Okay, so guys, you know, you can get this answer by using your answer options. But if you take, guys, if you take 900, you will not get 25, because 900 and 1000, what is the difference here? the difference is 100. Then 100 divided by 900, 1 by 9 is what? 1 by 9 is 11.11, but your answer has to be 25, no? When it is 1000 and 1000, there is a zero profit or loss. When it is 600 and 1000, the difference here is what? 400 divided by 600. Always this will become your cost price. So this is 2 by 3. 2 by 3 is what? 66.66. So this is not your answer. So definitely your answer is what? 800. Yeah. So now the point of what? This thing, guys. Discounts. Okay. Guys, discounts. Okay, we have, yeah. Okay, let me discuss discounts. If I have time, you know, I'll discuss in the evening simple interest, compound interest. Okay. So guys, tell me, discount. A businessman marks his goods at 50% above the cost price to attract the customers. He's allowing a 25% discount on market price. So what is the profit percentage? Yeah, I'll explain the concept with this question only. Okay, yes guys, quickly answer this. Okay guys, let's say your cost price of an article is 100. Okay, you marked the goods at 50% above the cost price, so your market price is going to be 150. To attract the customers, you are giving a discount of what? 25%. So 25% of 150. So how much discount you are giving? Everybody. 25% of 150 is what? Could you tell me the value? Anybody? Is it 37.5? How much is this? Is it 37.5? Yes. Okay, because 150 half is 75. 75 half only 37.5. Okay, so 150 minus 37.5 is 112.5. Okay, 112.5 is what your selling price. You brought it for 100 and you are selling it for 112.5. So your profit is going to be what? 12.5. Your profit percentage is going to be what? 12.5 divided by 100 into 100. Essentially, these two will get cancelled. Your answer is what? 12.5 is going to be your final answer. So two important points here, Ma. Guys, discount is always calculated only on market price. Discount is always calculated only on market price. Guys, tell me one more important point. Here the discount is 25%, no? Guys, like, you know, like let's say there is a loss of 20%. What is the selling price, Nana? There is a loss of 20%. The selling price is 80% of the cost price only, no? Yes or no, guys? There is 80% of cost price only, no? On the same note, if there is a discount of 25%, so here also the selling price would be 75% of market price. Okay, because discount, after discount only you will sell the goods. When there is a 25% of discount means 75% of market price. Let's check it out. Your market price is 100, Nana. You are giving a discount of 10%. What is your selling price, Ma? Your market price is 100. You are giving a discount of 10%. What is your selling price? It's obviously 90. Yes or no? It's obviously what here? 90. So can I conclude one point here? Okay. So why don't you calculate like this? Your selling price is nothing but when you are getting 10% discount, can I say 90% of market price only, no? Which means 90% of 100 only, no? Which means your answer is directly 90 only, no? Yes or no? So I want to tell you this. Loss percentage is 10%. Then selling price is what? 90% of cost price. There is a discount of 30%. So the selling price would be what? 70% of market price. Because discount is always calculated only on market price. Loss or profit is always calculated only on cost price. If you know these two points, you can solve so many questions in, you know, this particular. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. These are baby ones. You can do it. Guys, please try to solve this question. A trader brought goods at 1200. He wants to, uh, He wants to gain 15% on his goods. To attract the customers, he allow a discount of 25%. So what should be the cost price? Yeah, guys, tell me what is the answer for this nice question. Yes, guys, very good. 1840 is the correct answer. But how 1840 is the point? A trader brought goods at 1200. He wants to gain 15% on his goods. To attract the customers, you know, he allows a discount of 25%. So at what price should... Guys, tell me. So the cost price was given 1200, right? Nice question, you know. Please try to understand the situation. He wants to gain of 15%. Guys, tell me what, if you want to gain of 15%, you need to sell more than 1200. Tell me how much profit you need. If you want a gain of 15%, tell me profit in terms of rupees. So 15% of 1200. If you are good with tables, 15 into 12 will give you 180. Or you can do it 10% is 120, 5% is 60. So 120 plus 60 is what? 180. So can I say my selling price is going to be what here? My selling price is going to be 1380. Yeah, that's it. You got your answer. Because just now we discussed, to attract the customers, he's giving a discount of what? 25%. Guys, after discount only, you will sell your goods, right? Which means this is nothing but 75% of market price. Yes or no? So this is what? 75% of market price. You need to add, you want the market price, which is 100% of market price is what? How much? Then 100% of market price would be what? Okay, so 75% is this, then 100 would be what? Again, don't do this error. Don't calculate 25% of this value and don't add to it. Again, you will end up with the wrong one, because discount is always calculated only on market price, not on selling price. Please mind the gap. Okay, so 75% is this, then 100% would be what? If you calculate this, how much you are getting it? What is your answer? Yeah, what is your answer? Yeah, don't take any, yeah. 1840, are you getting 1840? Yes, and you, if you want to verify, you can verify. You can calculate 25% of this and you can subtract from this, you will get 1380 only. If you want, you can check it out. Can anybody tell me what is 25% of this value? Yeah, please once calculate and tell me. Yeah, I'll explain one more time. You know, yeah, your cost price is 1200. Okay, you want a profit of 15%. What is 15% of 1200? 180, which means your selling price is 1380. Okay, discount is always calculated on where? Discount is always calculated only on your market price. After a discount only, you will sell the goods, which means if your market price is 100%, you are giving a discount of 25%. Okay, so you will sell your goods after a discount only, no? Which means 75%. This value given in the question, which is 1380, we need 100%, which is market price. Then 100% is what? Just to do a cross multiplication, you can get your answer. Okay, you can get your answer. Okay, so guys, listen, one point. In today in your handout, in your practice questions, you will get a few questions from simple interest, compound interest also. So please, before going to those practice sheets, once remind your formulas in simple interest and compound interest, you know, then you can do that. So anyway, today I'll discuss first 10 to 15 minutes on simple interest, compound interest, then I'll discuss all those questions. Okay. So Shravani, want to talk to you. I think Shravani in the session. So Shravani, you can talk to them. Thank you guys. Thanks a lot for being in the session. So thank you.
Yeah. Thanks, Surya. So guys, please hold on. I just need 5-10 minutes to discuss with you. I'll not take much of your time. Okay. So I wanted to understand, like, if there is anybody who is like, you know, stuck with the registration process and all that. Okay. Please ping me in the chat box. And before I check the responses, Surya, can you please stop share? I want to share my screen. Okay, fine. So guys, I want to again show you this this platform. I want to again show you this platform. Shiny, please be on mute. Guys, whoever are joining, please be on mute. I'll just take 5 minutes and not more than that. Okay. So I want to show you this platform, guys, especially when I spoke on the starting day on 22nd, not many of you were present. So I would like to again show you this platform. This is the InfiTQ and Hackwith Infi portal, okay, where the learning content and sample tests are available. So as I said, you have to click on programs and click on certification, Infosys certification, and scroll up, you will see all the menus here. And in these menus, you have to go to learning content, okay? And you have the practice material available in the, in the portal itself. So in these courses, you have videos to watch, you have reading material, and you also have coding problems and MCQs to solve. So whichever language you choose here, on the right-hand side, there is something called a select language. So if you choose Python, then it will display all the Python courses. And if you choose Java, it will display all the Java courses. This is what I told on the first day. And for the others who have not yet registered, please register so that you can check all this on the platform. And one more thing is, from today, the mentors will be available. As I said, the mentors are like they have cracked InfiTQ and they are power programmers, and they are going to discuss the frequently asked questions only. So please, make utilization of the mentors. Mentors are going to send you the practice material and all that, what you have to practice. And irrespective of that, whatever you're practicing on this portal, if you have any doubts, please note that, and you can post your queries also to the mentor. Okay, so this is what I wanted to tell you, and I'm done with this. And apart from this, anybody else who has problem with registration and who wants to show me how to register and all that, please be on the line, please be on the call, and others can leave. If you don't have any queries, if you have something to talk to me, please post in the chat box. Otherwise, you can leave. And if you want me to show the registration also, please be on the line. I'll register and I'll show you. Okay, because InfiTQ, they might close the registrations at any moment. So please avoid last minute rush and, please register as soon as possible. Yeah, quick replies in the chat box, guys. Whoever are waiting, what do you want from me? Any questions, just post in the chat box. Or if you want me to show the registration also, you can, talk to me on that. If you have any kind of queries, just unmute and talk to me. Okay, so Chaitanya is asking, which college, Chaitanya? Please, guys, whenever you're asking a question, please post your branch and college also. College name and branch name, Chaitanya. Okay, yeah, you have DBMS sessions as well. For you, the programming sessions will start from 26th, Chaitanya. We will send a timetable, detailed timetable by today evening or tomorrow morning. And ma'am, I'm Ramya from Srimati's College. Yes, Ramya, tell me. Ramya, tell me, and Prishita, what is your query? I didn't understand. Ramya and Prishita, please tell me. Others who don't have any doubts, please leave. Can you tell again about the mentor? Okay, so what I was telling is, Prishita, mentors are available apart from the, what do you say, the trainer. We have programming trainer also, right? So apart from the training, we are also providing mentors for technical doubts clarification. If you have any doubts in Java and Python, they can clarify. All I'm saying is register for InfiTQ platform, and there is learning content available here, right? You can see on the screen. So you can solve this, and if you have any queries, you can ask the mentors on the mentee group. And apart from that, the mentors are also going to share the practice material. And if you have any queries in the practice material also, you can ask. Like every day they're going to share the practice questions to be done. That's what I meant. Okay, so somebody, Ramya is saying, I'm unable to register for Hack with Infi. Is that what you're saying? Okay, Hack with Infi, I have not yet posted about the PPT of how to register. I'll do that, okay? I'll do that in some time. I think you should be able to do Hack with Infi also, because in this portal itself, there is something called as in the programs, go to programs and click on Hack with Infi. And here, I think you have, what do you say, the screen is there and you can, there's something called as register now. You have to click on, I have read the terms and conditions, and you have to click on just to register now. So please check once again, Ramya, in the same portal of InfiTQ, there is something, one menu called as programs. Click on programs and you have to click on Hack with Infi, and this screen appears. And in this screen, you have to click on the terms and conditions, and then register now will appear. Okay, please try again. The recording sessions cannot be extended. Okay, like whomever we are sharing, it cannot be extended. Samir, I think I answered the question. Hack with Infi, I just showed. And again, I'll try to send the PPT or detailed PPT of how to register for Hack with Infi. It is pretty much easy. If you are already on the portal of InfiTQ, then you have to click on. Yeah, just a minute. Whoever is talking, just a minute. Click on programs and go to Hack with Infi, and you can see the screen. And you have to click on the terms and conditions, and the register now button is open. So I think I've answered your query. And yeah, someone was talking, please tell me.
Ma'am, Hack with Infi is the last date is 28th on, you know, for registration.
Hack with Infi, okay. I think the contest for Hack with Infi is going to be sometime in May, okay. So May 5th and 7th or something they told. Did they give deadline also? Because 5th May and 7th May or 9th May is something they are saying. And okay, you will get slots by April 2nd or 3rd, I think. Okay, I'll find out about the deadline to, you know, register for Hack with Infi, and I'll let you know. I'll post in the groups. Is that fine? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay. And guys, one more thing is, don't assume thinking that InfiTQ, if you register, then you will be eligible for Hack with Infi also. It is not the case, because we have attended the meeting of Infosys, and they clearly stated that the students have to register twice, once for InfiTQ and once for Hack with Infi. So most of them have seen that they have registered only for either Hack with Infi or InfiTQ. please make sure that you register for both, because the package is really good for both, in fact. So please don't miss the chance. This is your first opportunity. Okay, I see 155 more students online. Anybody who wants me to show the registration process, pretty much very detailed. I have, you know, sent the PPT of registration process of InfyTQ. That's pretty much self-explanatory. But however, if you have any queries while registering, you know, something you're not able to understand, you can just ask me. You can just unmute and talk to me. Otherwise, please leave, guys, because I see 100 plus students still online. Any doubts, I'll give 5 more minutes and then I'll end the session if nobody has doubts. If you want me to show the registration also, do let me know. I need quick responses. Okay, I'll wait for 5 minutes. Okay, Padmini is saying, ma'am, we are unable to manage this long schedule as we are having semester exams approaching. I understand, I totally understand, Padmini. We are very sorry for that, but we cannot help you. Only you guys only tell us what can be done, because Infosys is not ready to, like, you know, extend the dates and all, and the exam is on 2nd and 3rd of April. So we hardly have 1 week's time and less than that. And we are trying to do our best possible. So you'll have to manage somehow. I can't help. I'm really sorry for that. Okay. Can I end the meeting, guys? I don't see any queries or something. Anybody who wants, like, you know, me to show the registration process, or if you have any doubts and you're not able to register also, let me know.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, please tell me.
Actually, I'm not able to register to Hack with Infy, ma'am. It is displayed as something eligibility criteria. I think I did a mistake in registration form.
Yeah, good question. Yeah. So, see, most of them, while registering and while giving their details in the profile, their year of passing out have to be correct. So year of passing out has to be 2022, because you guys are 2022 pass outs.
Yes.
If you choose as 2021 or 2020 or any other than 2022, then it is, the system will not allow you to go forward. So that's why, if you see here on my screen, the Hack with Infy eligibility is clearly mentioned as BE, BTech, ME, MTech students 2022 batch. So
yes,
you please go back and check, because most of the students have made the same mistake. So please go back and check change there, and then you'll be able to, you know, the system will take you forward to the registration.
So how can I register again, ma'am?
No, you don't have to register again. I don't know. In fact, you have to go to your profile somewhere. You have to find here where is your profile, and you have to edit that, I suppose, because that's what in my PPT also I clearly mentioned, that, you know, your year of passing have to be correctly mentioned.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Yeah, just try. I mean, I'll also here in the terms and conditions, there's some, can you see a grid box here on the right hand corner? If I click on that, all this is appearing. So here there is something called as my data. Can you see here?
Yes, ma'am.
Here there is profile. Click on profile and try, maybe if you're able to, you know, edit your year of passing and all that. I think you should be able to year, edit. Here, can you see year of completion is 2022?
Yes,
ma'am. Only if you, you know, add here as 2022, it is going to, you know, take you further. And I don't see here any edit option. So I don't know, like, you know, if you really can edit it or you have to provide another email ID or something. That's why be careful, guys, everybody. It just takes 5-10 minutes of, you know, concentratedly. If you do, then you can avoid.
If it is not possible, I can give another email ID, ma'am.
Yes, but actually you have to avoid giving, you know, too many email IDs because you are confusing your college, your the company and intern, everybody, because company will send the information to your college and to us, like, you know, how many have registered and all that. So there might be duplications because your roll number might be the same and, like, you understand, right? Your roll number might be the same and you're just changing the email ID. So they'll not understand the duplications. Avoid it. Try seeing if there is any edit option available here. But otherwise, if you have to take the exam, then you have to do it with some other source, like, you know, some other email ID.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. Thank you so much.
Any other queries, guys? Even if you feel that it is silly also, please ask me. It is fine. But if you don't have any questions, please leave the meeting, guys. Just 2 more minutes, I'll wait, and then I'll only end the meeting.
Can you please repeat when the last date for Hackify is?
Sorry?
The last date registered for Hackify.
Hack with Infi, last date for registration, that's what I'll find out and I'll let you know, because I think it's still open, and Hack with Infi will usually be in the month of May. So let's see. I mean, I'll check with them and I'll get back to you on this, but do it as soon as possible. It just takes a minute. Like, if you have already registered for InfiTQ, then you have to go to the menu of programs, click on Hack with Infi, and this is the screen that appears. Just simply click on, I have read the terms and conditions, and click on register now. That's it.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Yes, ma'am.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, tell me.
Ma'am, I have changed it in the profile, but still it is showing the same thing, that eligibility criteria.
Log out and, you know, log in again and do it. No? Refresh okay. And check. If you're still not able to do, then I think you have to... change the ID. Before that, you just text me on WhatsApp. I mean, with the screenshot of what it is showing, then I'll be able to do something.
Sure, ma'am. Okay.
Yeah. Any queries, guys? Any more queries? I still see 72 in. Do you all want me to show the registration process and that's why you're in the meeting, or how is it? Like, please clarify in the chat box. Okay, I think no more queries, and we are ending the meeting, guys. Thank you. Surya, can you please end the meeting?
Thank you, ma'am.
Thanks.